important meeting, and it's a pleasure to welcome our former friend, our former colleague and good friend, Mel Watt. You are missed on this committee. Director Watt has been on the job for 386 days, and he has proven to be a thoughtful, deliberative, and conscientious leader of this tremendously important agency. He has focused on maintaining the liquidity of the mortgage markets and on increasing access to credit for credit-worthy borrowers. For example, his first act as director of FHFA was to delay a planned increase in Fannie and Freddie's guarantee fees, which would have raised G fees even more in states with stronger consumer protections, such as the one I represent. There was never a sound basis for penalizing states that have strong consumer protections in foreclosure, and I applaud Director Watt for this decision. States that have strong consumer protections should be rewarded, not penalized. In addition, he halted the arbitrary 10% cuts to Fannie and Freddie's multifamily businesses and created an exception for small and affordable multifamily housing. This is hugely important for my district, where multifamily housing is our single family business. He has also allowed Fannie and Freddie to buy certain mortgages with a 3% down payment, which will allow borrowers with strong credit histories, but not stockpiles of extra cash, to get a mortgage. I think that decision is tremendously important, and he was guided by the data, which clearly demonstrates that the size of the down payment is not the most important factor in predicting default rates. Finally, he recently made the decision to start funding the National Housing Trust Fund and the Capital Magnet Fund, which will provide hundreds of millions of dollars for affordable housing programs. This was a critically important decision because this is one of the only dedicated sources of funding for affordable housing that we have. Thank you very much. We're delighted to have you back here before the committee.
Gentlelady yields back directly.